Hello friends, today in this presentation we will discuss measurement of density in mixed traffic flow. And as you might be knowing, there are three fundamental flow parameters: speed, volume and density. Measurement of speed and traffic volume or traffic flow is quite straightforward, but density is relatively difficult to measure in field. And therefore, it is generally calculated using this fundamental relationship between flow density and space mean speed. So we measure flow and speed in field and calculate density using this equation. This equation was given by John Wardrop in 1952, and it was derived under certain assumptions. And assumptions are that all vehicles are moving on the road are of same size, all vehicles are moving in the same speed, and spacing between vehicles may be different, but it does not change with time. That means it is for uniform traffic flow of vehicles of same size moving at same speed. And as you can appreciate, that none of these assumptions is true in real traffic flow conditions. Now, opinion of researchers is quite divided on this subject. Some believe that this equation is valid in all traffic conditions, and others believe it is not. Now, to validate this equation, you need to collect all three parameters in field, and today's lecture is on measurement of density under mixed traffic condition. As I told you, measurement of traffic volume and traffic speed is quite straightforward. Now, there are two broad methods of measuring density. One, what we call direct method, like XT method, NT method, or highway capacity manual method. And indirect methods are time occupancy and area occupancy. They do not give the density directly, but you can calculate density using these two methods also. Now, I'll explain all the five methods first and then demonstrate how density is calculated using them. In XT method, which is based on Eddy's definition of parameters, you plot trajectory of different vehicles moving on the road. So let us say you have a loop detector here and a loop detector here, and this is the distance between two loop detectors. And on time space diagram, you plot the trajectory of each vehicle and then calculate using this chart, using this plot, calculate how much time each vehicle will be devoting in this loop and how much distance the vehicle will be traveling. And then these parameters are defined like this, that flow is the total distance traveled by all vehicles in AN. AN is this area, yellow color area, divided by total area of shaded region AN. So distance is DAN divided by AN. That is the flow. And density is the total time spent by all vehicles in AN, that is time TAN divided by the area. This is the density. And space mean speed is the total distance divided by total time in the area. So these definitions are such that it gives you very accurate measure of traffic stream characteristics. And it also satisfies the fundamental equation Q is equal to K into V. You can see here that this equation is also satisfied. And this method is not sensitive to detector spacing. So the area of this area can be of any size. Now, drawback of this method is that it is very tedious and time consuming, because it requires vehicle trajectory of each and every vehicle, and this method generally is not used because it is not practical. In NT method, what we do that we draw the cumulative arrival and departure of vehicles at the upstream and downstream of the trap length. So you draw a trap length on the highway. It can be automatic loop detectors. Count the number of vehicles in the upstream direction with time, and count the number of vehicles in downstream point with time, and then make a plot of this. So this is the plot: cumulative number of vehicles on y-axis and time on x-axis, and this is ut, this is dt. Now if you take at any point, at any time t, if you take this vertical distance between these two curves, that will give you the number of vehicles in the trap. That is the instantaneous density. So density will be given by this equation, and you can use any mathematical formula to find out this ut minus dt and measure the density. The merits of NT method is that it also gives quite accurate measurement of density. Method is quite handy and quick, as it uses the data directly obtained from loophole detectors. Result of NT method does not depend upon the detector spacing, and this method also validates the fundamental traffic equation. Drawback: the vehicles present in the trap before the count starts and the vehicles left within the trap after finishing the count should be properly accounted for, otherwise it may lead to error in the density value. Now the third method is as suggested in Highway Capacity Manual of US. Now what the manual says that the density can be found by taking a snapshot of the road at bit of the time interval. So if you are measuring, let us say if you are taking 5-minute traffic volume count and 5-minute speed data, then take a snapshot of the road at 2.5 minute and count the number of vehicles in the snapshot, and that is the density. Naturally, it is valid for uniform flow, and it gives highly misleading results in case of random or mixed traffic flow. Now, two indirect methods, as I told you, a time occupancy and area occupancy methods. Now, time occupancy is defined as the proportion of time during which detection zone is occupied by vehicles. So it is given by sigma ti upon t, where small ti is the time during which trap length is covered by vehicle I, and capital T is total observation period. And you can find out, using this, you can find out the density as 1000 time occupancy divided by average length of vehicle plus trap length. Now, in case of mixed traffic, this average length of vehicle can be estimated roughly using this equation, summation of Li Pi upon 100, where Li is the length of each vehicle category and Pi is the proportion of that vehicle category I. In area occupancy method, this area occupancy is expressed as the proportion of time during which the set of observed vehicles occupy the chosen stretch of a roadway. So here you mark the area on the road and find out what is the time ti during which a stretch of a roadway is occupied by vehicle I having area ai. And capital A is the area of the whole of the road stretch, and T is the total observation period. And this can also be used to find out the density: area occupancy multiplied by road width divided by average size of vehicle. Now, to illustrate these five methods, we collected some data on a 4-lane divided urban arterial in Jaipur, and we made a trap of 30 meter on the road and estimated 5-minute traffic volume count, and for every observation, traffic volume, composition and space mean speed of each vehicle were determined. So when I say one data set, it means basically 5-minute data, and that was traffic number of vehicles counted in 5 minutes were projected to 1 hour. Now, NT method I told you XT method is not very practical, and therefore we are not using that method here. The first method is NT method. So we plotted this cumulative curve at upstream and downstream of the trap area, and the area between these two curves gives you the total number of vehicles. Now this method, you see here, if you take, let us say, 6 data set, the flow which is counted, actually counted in field, space mean speed for each data set, and virtual density. Now virtual density here, I mean when you calculate this density using flow and space mean speed, flow divided by space mean speed, and this is the density using NT method. You can see here how closely these figures are, and therefore the percentage error in 6 data set is about 1.7%. Maximum is 2.76 and minimum is 0.148. So you can see that this method gives you quite accurate density measurement. Now highway capacity manual method gives a very misleading result, and it is because I told you that it says that you take snapshot at the midpoint of the counting period and count the number of vehicles, and that is the density. So this virtual density, same from the earlier table, is compared with measured density, that is the counting of vehicles in the trap, and you can see here that the variation or the error varies from 39% to 100%, and there could be situations where there is no vehicle in the trap. The time occupancy method also gives quite good result. Average error here is just 7.64%, and area occupancy method also gives results which has error of average error of 5.6%. Now these two methods, time occupancy method and area occupancy method, are also quite laborious, as they also require calculation for each vehicle in the trap and in each time interval, and therefore they also are not very popular. The popular method is highway capacity manual method, that you take a snapshot in 1 kilometer length of the highway and count the number of vehicles. So as I have shown you that this method in its present form gives you very misleading result, and therefore we try to modify this method. Rather than taking a single snapshot, we suggested a number of snapshots rather than just one. For accurate density, the time interval should tend to zero. That means there should be infinite number of snapshots, which is not practical. And therefore, we should find out what is the minimum snapshot required to have a density which is within acceptance of error. Now, this slide shows you the difference. Now, at time is equal to 100 second of a, let us say, data set, you find here there are 4 vehicles in the trap. At time is equal to 200 second also, there are 4 vehicles, but all are motorbikes. So density is 4. Okay, density is 4, but the level of congestion will be different. But at time is equal to 300 second, there is no vehicle in the trap, and that is the zero density. And it is because the arrival is not uniform. Arrival is random, which is generally the case on the highway. So if random, in case of random arrival, there are chances of having a varying density at different times. So we took number of snapshots rather than a single snapshot at the mid of the interval, time interval. We took one shot, 3, 5, 7, 9, 11 and 15. And these are the data sets, 10 data sets. And you can see here in the last column that the average error goes on reducing as we increase the number of snapshots, and it becomes less than 10% if you take 15 snapshots in a time interval of 5 minutes. Now this is how basically it varies, average percent error with the number of observations in a count period. So result depends upon number of observations per count period, what the trap length, traffic volume and traffic composition. And therefore, in this research, we try to study effect of each of these parameters on the density. And since these parameters cannot be varied in field, we perform simulation on 4-lane divided highway. Traps of 100 meter, 200 meter, 300 meter and up to 1000 meter were made. Number of observations were fixed, 10 per simulation. And density was measured using proposed method in each trap length, and then error was calculated. So the trap which gives the error in density measurement equal to or less than 5% was taken as the minimum trap length, and then this procedure was repeated for different traffic volumes and composition. Now these are the results for all car situation and a traffic volume of 2000 vehicles per hour. The trap length was from 100 meter to 1000 meter, and these are the observations. So you can see here that the percent error reduces as the trap length increases and is zero at 1000 meter. That is natural because that is the definition of the density. And this figure shows you that a traffic volume of 3000 vehicles per hour, how the average error in density reduces with the trap length. And for this condition of traffic volume, the requirement of trap length will be somewhere between 800 meter and 900 meter, so that you have an error of less than 5%. Now, similar exercise was done for different traffic volumes for all car situation, and you can see here that the minimum tramp length required reduces as traffic volume increases, and it is because at high traffic volume the flow tends to be uniform rather than random. Now what then we try to insert two wheelers in the traffic stream and see the effect of traffic volume. Now it's now mixed traffic, car plus two wheelers, how the requirement of minimum trap length changes with percentage of two wheelers at different traffic volume of 2000, 3000 and 5000. Now here also the minimum trap length reduces as traffic volume increases. Similarly, we did it for traffic volume and traffic composition. Trap length was now fixed at 100 meter. Just to see the effect of traffic volume and composition, number of observations were fixed at 10 per simulation, and density was measured using proposed method, that is the average of 10 observations, and density was also calculated by dividing flow to space mean speed, and the error between the two densities were determined. And the whole process was repeated at different traffic volume and traffic composition, and it gives you the percent error in all car situation as traffic volume increases. You can see here this is increasing at very fast rate and comes down to almost 3% when traffic volume is 3500-3400 vehicles per hour. But when you add two wheelers here, the situation is slightly different. Now the percent error here is that this yellow curve is for all car situation, and these are the curves when you add two wheelers. So percent error increases even the same traffic volume. Percent error in case of 10% two wheeler, 20% and 30% two wheeler, because they are small in size and therefore flow becomes random rather than uniform. But in case of heavy vehicle, you can see that this is the 5%, 10% and 15%. The trend is reversed because heavy vehicles create situation where congestion will be more as number of heavy vehicles increases, and therefore flow tend to be more uniform. In case of light commercial vehicle, it is similar to heavy vehicle because they are larger than car, and therefore finally what we did, we made an equation that if you take 100 meter trap length and you have a, let us say, particular traffic volume with these three category of vehicles, heavy vehicle, two wheeler, car and LCV, this is likely to be percent error in the density measurement. If you take 10 snapshots, if you increase the trap length to 300 meter, then this will reduce and can be calculated using this equation. Now, beyond 300 meter trap length, it is not really possible to have the snapshot unless you use drones. And therefore, generally what we do, we make a trap on the highway or on the road of either 100 meter or maximum 150 meter and then measure the density. So finally, XT method is accurate, but it is not practical. NT method is also accurate and it is suited for roads installed with loophole detector so that you can automatically get the number of arrivals at the upstream point and downstream point. The HCM method gives you instantaneous density at the time when you take the snapshot, and therefore it can give you highly misleading results in mixed traffic and random flow. Time occupancy method and area occupancy method give quite good results but doesn't closely represent the concentration on a roadway in case of mixed traffic conditions. The method which we proposed here, that is the modification of highway capacity manual method, it says that as the number of observations in a time interval is increased, the error in density measurement reduces rapidly, and at least 15 snapshots are needed for a 5-minute count to reduce the error below 10%. So thank you very much for watching this video. Please share the link of this video to your friends.